Greetings from Talent Battle. Hello everyone, I am Rohit. Welcome to our new video. In this video, we are going to solve the previous year MCQ questions for Accenture Drive based on network security and cloud. This video will help you to prepare for it. Also, you can join our masterclass training where we are going to cover all these previous year questions. Also, join our social media handles like Telegram groups, Instagram page, WhatsApp group, and we constantly update the placement preparation updates and off-campus updates too. Links to all these handles is given in the video description. So before we start, don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for instant notifications about our videos. Let's move on to the actual content for this video. The first question: which of the following cloud service providers should be preferred if most of your data is of binary large objects type? So for solving such kind of questions related to the network security and the cloud computing, you need to have the basic understanding about the network devices specifically. And in cloud computing, you need to have the architectural information about the cloud service providers, their platform informations, what are the different cloud service providers we have, what kind of architectural working they possess. If this information is well known to you, you can solve the questions related to that. Now for this question, the binary large objects type, it is actually called as BLOB storage devices. This concept is called as BLOB storage devices. Now we have to find that which of the following cloud service providers should be preferred if most of your data is related to this. So if your data is related to the binary large object types, we need to identify the cloud service provider who is matching or whose architecture is matching with such kind of objects type. So if such kind of object types are there, binary large objects, the Microsoft Azure is a cloud service provider who is offering this kind of storage devices where you can have the data related to BLOB, right? So my answer for this question is option D, Microsoft Azure. This is the only platform provided by Microsoft, cloud service provider, which is going to offer the BLOB storage devices, right? Moving to the next question. Question number two, the DES encryption algorithm is an example of which of the following options? Now you need to have the information about the DES encryption algorithm, that is data encryption algorithm, which is normally used for encryption. So it is related to the cryptography. Now, the DES is actually a block cipher algorithm, right? DES is a block cipher algorithm that takes your plain text. So the conversion of plain text to the cipher text is going to happen when it comes to encryption. Plain text to cipher text. This process is called as encryption, conversion of plain text to cipher text. But how this conversion happens, that my plain text is taking 64 bits of block, right? So here itself you get an idea that we are taking bits into consideration, and when you convert it to the cipher text, it comes out to be 48 bits. Now again, it depends data to data and the logic what you are applying for this conversion, but it is oriented on the basis of bit values, right? So, and as it is a symmetric key algorithm, which means that the same key is going to be used for encryption and decryption also. If suppose I am using key 1 for this encryption process, the same key I will use for key 1, that is decryption process, means conversion from cipher text to plain text, that is called as decryption. So that's why it is called as a symmetric algorithm, and it is mostly oriented on the basis of bits values, right? So answer for this question, that DES encryption algorithm is an example of which of the following option? So it is a bit oriented cipher, because the entire process is bit oriented, right? So that's why the answer for this question is option A. Let's move on to the next question. See, which of the following statement is true about cloud and data center? Now read both the statements. First one, in cloud, owner is responsible for downtime and repairs. So cloud and data center, you need to first identify the differences between these, and then you can solve this question. So data center is an physical architecture, you can say, the infrastructure where the responsibility for downtimes and repairs is specifically under the category of owner, because they are providing you the services. So if they are providing you the services, they will be responsible for the cases of downtime and repairs related to the maintenance part. So your traditional data centers, which are having that, requires a lot of maintenance on the basis of this. And according to that, they build their infrastructure, right? So it is related to the infrastructure, what they have been providing to you on the account of services. So maintenance part comes into the picture here. And then who is responsible for this? So to perform this maintenance on the account of infrastructure, your owner is responsible. Whereas, and in case of data centers, the owners are fully responsible for all these cases. Whereas cloud, that is a kind of service that has been provided. It is built and maintained by the cloud service providers. Like your Amazon Web Services are there, Google Cloud is there. They are responsible. Owner is not responsible here for performing the downtime and repairs cases. So that's why the first statement is not true. Second is true in this case. Right? So only two, option B is the correct answer. Right? So we have to choose the correct answer, and only two, second statement is correct over here. Right? Let's move on to the next question. Attack in which a user creates a packet that appears to be something else is called as. So here the information about the network attacks is important here that you should have so that you can solve these questions. Now, what kind of attack is this where user creates a packet that appears to be something else? So when such kind of technique is used where you create a separate packet and it appears to be something else, means suppose you are opening a mail and that mails look like a familiar one, but when you open that mail, you come to know that that is a kind of attack happened on your system. So this process is called as spoofing, this kind of process, right? So option D is the correct answer. And what about these other cases? So the attack is a kind of spoofing attack here, where user creates a packet that appears to be something else or from someone else. That is also possible here. Someone else case. In the case of smurfing, the smurfing attack is a distributed DDoS, right? So that is called as distributed denial of service attack, where the large number of ICMP packets are being traversed or being provided onto the victim's system, where the source IP address and the broadcast to a computer network using that IP broadcasting can be done. So this kind of attack where ICMP packets are broadcasted through the IP network, that is called as smurfing. The Trojan horse or a Trojan kind of attack is a malicious code or software that actually looks like a legitimate one, legal one, but it can take the control of your computer, right? And the basic agenda, motto behind that is the damage or destroy the information that your computer consists of or a system consists of. Any kind of harmful activity that can be happened. And email bombing is nothing but the, again, DOS attack where denial of service is done and it the multiple emails, right? Huge number of emails have been provided which are unusable in this case. So whenever the packet is created and which appears to be something else, this kind of attack is called as spoofing, right? So I have given information for all the possible options. So option D is the correct option here for this particular question. Let's move on to the next question. Now here they are asking about another attack again, an attack in which the user receives an unwanted amount of emails, right? So in the previous question, we have discussed this part, that unwanted amount of emails has been received. So what we can say, email bombing, right? Because here unwanted emails have been provided to the user system so that there should not be any access. So this is a kind of DOS attack. We called it as denial of service, denial of service attack. Right, where user is being fully loaded with the email so that he will not be able to access the legitimate services. So option C is the correct answer in this question, right? Question next, 6. Which of the following types of network security ensures that potential attackers cannot infiltrate your network? So what kind of network security is responsible for this or going to ensure that potential attackers cannot infiltrate, means cannot enter your network? So we have to check for the network security options out of this, which is possible in that case. So if you have the knowledge about firewalls, virtual private networks and network access controls, then you can solve these questions. Now, what mostly happens when it comes to network security, we need to understand one by one all of them. So, firewall is what? It is a network security system that actually monitors and controls the incoming and outgoing traffic related to the network. And we have to assign certain security rules to that firewall also. So, if certain rules are been satisfied, the trusted systems are there, so they will allow the traffic, otherwise they will block the traffic. So, it is related to the trusted and untrusted network. The network access control is the actually identification of unauthorized users and devices which are out of your private network. Suppose organization is having certain things and outside that organization you are actually dealing with the private network. So there are certain advantages also, like authentication is done most of the cases. The secure system and secure identifying users on the basis of IP addresses are also done in case of your usernames and password in network access control. But here again the potential attackers can infiltrate if you get this kind of information to them. A virtual private network, the third option, is actually a kind of connection between security and privacy in between the public and private network, right? So suppose this is your organization which consists of private network, right? This is a private network you have within the organization and you are actually connected to a public network. This is my public network full of illegal users, right? They can try to access the information. So in between here, these connections, you can have a virtual private network, right? Because your initial IP address are going to get replaced here in the virtual IP, virtual network, and they will provide you the new one. On the basis of that, from any gateway, if you are trying to access the service, that IP address is necessary, right? Say for example, you are living in XYZ city or within the organization, right? So due to that virtual private network, your identification has been changed. Virtually it is showing another city name like that. So it will be difficult for potential attackers to infiltrate in your network. So answer for this question is option C, virtual private network, which is a better one that ensures the potential attackers cannot infiltrate in your network, right? Let's move on to the next question. Antivirus scanning devices falls under which type of network security device? Now here the information about the antivirus scanning devices and the various types of networking security devices are important to solve this question. So first understand all these network security devices and then we'll try to identify where antivirus belongs to. So active devices means what? The devices which are blocking the traffic, like firewalls are there. Antiviruses are also there because they are blocking on the basis of given rules and filters in the network which actually filter the contents on the basis of provided rules. Right? So my antivirus actually comes under the category of active devices. So option A is the correct one. Apart from that, I will give you certain information about these options also. Like preventative devices means you are preventing the certain things to be happen first. So the devices such as vulnerability assessment is there, potential threats you are identifying and try to prevent them for happening certain process, that will comes under the category of preventiveness. Threat management devices, unified threat management, it is like web catching, content filtering also comes here. And in passive devices, you will have intrusion detection systems, which are passive actually, right? They wait for certain things to happen and then they will become active. So option A is the correct option, where antiviruses are belongs to active devices, which relates to the type of network security device. Okay, so let's move to the next question. Now they have provided us a particular situation on the basis of cloud service providers, and you have to identify which cloud service provider will be best suitable for this kind of situation. So consider a situation where you have to choose between the major cloud service providers. Which would you choose if you want to support for Linux, Windows Server and SQL Server as well as enhanced security? So all these four possible features, if any one of the cloud service provider is providing all these features, that is your answer. Now here you should have the knowledge about the services provided by these providers and you can solve this question, right? Now here if you check, Linux, Windows Server, so multiple platforms are there as well as SQL Server and the enhanced security, right? So if you have the knowledge of all these platforms, I would like to give you the idea that Microsoft Azure is the service provider who works on all these four features as compared to other this, because Google Cloud does not provide you backup, so enhanced security can be there, cannot be there. Your Alibaba and Oracle, they are working on the hybrid kind of thing, hybrid network they provide. So it is difficult for them to provide all these services related to the various servers. So Microsoft Azure is the only open source platform actually that is compatible with this Linux also, Windows servers also, SQL servers also, and SAP applications as well, right? So that's why Microsoft Azure is the correct answer for this particular case. Again, I would like to repeat the same thing, that you need to have the knowledge about the cloud service providers, their working mechanism, what kind of architecture they use, and that will help you to solve such questions. The next question, it is related to again encryption, that how many processes are there for changing a plain text piece of data into encrypted data in AES. So we have seen the encryption process is based on the conversion of plain text to cipher text. But while doing this, there are certain factors which are involved, and on the basis of their dependency, this process is going to happen. So we are going to use key, and the length of this key is not fixed, but in certain algorithms related to the length of the plain text and the length of the key, you can be very sure about the kind of data. Like there are variations of algorithms of advanced encryption standards 128. So it means that it will take 128 bits, right? The key value will be 128 bits in this case, if I am talking about AES 128. Again, there are various variations, like it is AES 256, so that will take 256 bits of key. Then 192 is also there. So on the basis of this, how many rounds, right? How many rounds, how many processes are there for changing this piece of data? We normally call them as how many rounds you will take to perform the conversion from plain text to cipher text. That is the process of encryption. So when it comes to 128 bits, right? 128 bits, it usually takes 10 rounds, right? So 10 is our correct answer in this case. Apart from that, we have 256 bits also, key length. For 256 bits, it will take 14 rounds, and for 192, it will take 12 rounds. So they might change the questions on the basis of this. So you need this information. So if there are 128 bits in the encrypted standard key, this is key value. This is the length of the key, key length. On the account of that, this information is important. 10 processes or 10 rounds, 14 processes and 12 processes. And here in this question, they have asked specifically about 128 bits key length. So my answer is option D. That is 10 rounds will be required, or 10 processes will be required, depending upon the length of the key, that is 128, that is being calculated for the original value of the key on the basis of advanced encryption standard, right? Let's move on to the next question. Which of the following cloud service provider does not provide hybrid storage? See, earlier also I have given you the idea related to this, that which of the following cloud service provider does not provide hybrid storage. Does not provide, right? They are expecting the answer that does not provide the hybrid storage. So multiple way, right? Hybrid storage means what? You can have the multiple platforms for storing the data, right? That. So various services are there for these platforms. They will provide actually the hybrid storage. And apart from that, Google Cloud and IBM, these two service providers are there. They don't provide any kind of hybrid storage over there, right? And they are asking who is not providing. So answer D is the correct answer. Apart from that, AWS and Azure, they have their hybrid storage mechanism. They have their services, like say, for example, AWS provides a gateway service that is dependent on the hybrid storage kind thing. Then Azure is having its own simple store kind of service that is also dependent on the hybrid storage. And Alibaba has already I told you that it is already having a hybrid storage kind of mechanism. So that's why it is not supporting other servers. But here for this question, it was like does not provide the case. So option D, Google Cloud, is the correct option for this, right? So if you have the information about the data service providers, their architectural information and networking devices and various attacks, you can solve these questions for this particular section. So I hope you got the entire idea and all the questions. Thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel. Thank you.